Hallelujah. We bless the name of Jesus. We welcome you back with us this morning. Those of us who are joining us live on Facebook, online, we certainly welcome you this morning, and we certainly appreciate the fact that we are still in accordance with the law, being in accordance with God's word, to worship and give him what is due unto him, nevertheless, by joining us online. Welcome one and all as you join us in your living rooms, in your bedrooms, in maybe your bathroom, wherever it is, wherever you're comfortable this morning. Welcome. We certainly welcome the Holy Spirit, which is right here with us at 33 to 39 Portmore Drive, and the Spirit of God, which is right there with you in your place of abode. We want to welcome just the persons that are here, the few persons that are here with us, the worship team, the musicians, and we want to make welcome our assistant pastor who is here with us, Reverend Melissa Davis Gibbs. Yes, right where you are, you can put your hands together for her. Hallelujah. And I'm almost certain that our senior pastor is joining us live on Facebook. We want to give honor and respect due to the man of God also, and make him welcome right where he is, he and his lovely wife, Reverend Walters. Put your hands together for him. Hallelujah. Other leaders would be usually seated on the platform, Reverend Marjorie Brissett Dyer and Minister Winsome Briscoe. And let's leave that alone. We welcome her also. We welcome them also. God bless you. Please put your hands together for them. And for the few moments that you will see me today, I'm sure you're familiar with me, but for those of you who are joining us for the first time, I'm Minister David Williams. It's a pleasure to be serving this morning. I'm going to be inviting at this time our assistant pastor, the Reverend Dr. Melissa Davis Gibbs, to come and give us greetings. God bless you.
Good morning, everyone, all those here and those viewing online. It's good to be worshiping together and from a distance. God bless you. Our speaker this morning is no stranger to some of us, but he is to some of you, perhaps. He is a mighty man of God. He is a teacher by profession. He is a graduate of the then Jamaica Open Bible Institute of Jamaica, now the College of Theological and Interdisciplinary Studies. He is married to Cadian and the father of two sons. And he's a member of this church. He's no other than our brother, the youth minister, Brother Gregory Jones. Just before he comes, we'll be collecting the offering. And before him also will be Brother Nicardo Benbow, who will be doing a ministry item. The Lord bless you and do enjoy the service.
Morning, everyone, and to our online viewers this morning. You know, in light of what's happening in the world right now, we have to remember that the Lord God is our help, and our help only comes from our sovereign God. And while we experience layoffs and job cuts and debts and all of that, you know, we should still be cognizant of the fact that our God is our provider, our God is our sustainer, and our God is our keeper throughout this difficult time. Amen. Amen.
My eyes to the hills, from whence cometh my help? My help cometh from the Lord, the Lord which made heaven and earth. He said he would not suffer thy foot to be moved. The Lord which keepeth thee, he will not slumber nor sleep. Oh, the Lord is thy keeper. The Lord is the shade upon thy right hand. Upon thy right hand. Oh, the sun shall not smite thee by day, nor the moon by night. He shall preserve my soul, and even forevermore. My help, my help, my help. All of my
suffer thy foot to be moved.
The Lord is keeping
thee.
He will not slumber.
The
Lord is my keeper. The Lord is my shade. So
oh. reminded that they are help. They are help. Hallelujah. They are help. They are help. Come on. Come on. Praise and worship.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
For the Lord is my keeper.
The Lord is my shepherd.
Upon thy right hand. Upon thy right hand. Though the sun shall not smite me by day, nor the moon by night, he shall preserve my soul, even forevermore.
Hallelujah. Our help, our help, our help cometh from the Lord. I know we are not in church in the conventional way, but I wish somebody would lift their hands at home. I wish you would lift your hands in your bedroom, your living room, in your kitchen. You're making breakfast or lunch, but your help cometh this morning. He says he's your very present help when you're in trouble. And isn't the world in trouble this morning? But our help, Brother David, our help cometh. While they look, while the world is looking east, west, north, and south, we will lift up our eyes unto the hills from whence cometh our help. Hallelujah! Hallelujah! Give him praise this morning. Wherever you are, give him some praise. Give him the praise that he deserves this morning, because our help, our help, our help, our help, my God, our help cometh from the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We are happy to be in the house of the Lord one more time. Hallelujah. 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 We're still gonna have church this morning. No matter what, hell or high water, we're gonna have church. No coronavirus, no quarantine, no lockdown can stop us from having church. Hallelujah. 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 Welcome those who are at home. It's a small gathering at church. I'm used to a small gathering. I actually preach my best messages in my bathroom. I preach to myself all the time. So numbers were good. I want to thank the Lord this morning for this opportunity to gather a setting, a small setting, but we give thanks nevertheless, and we big you up on the internet. We want to acknowledge those who need to be acknowledged. Our senior pastor, Reverend Alwyn Walters, and our assistant pastors, Reverend Melissa Gibbs, Minister David Williams, Reverend Winsome Briscoe Addition, to all the ministers, members of the board, leaders in the church, welcome. Musicians, I'm going to help me preach this morning because there's nobody out here to help me preach. So I can't left me this morning. So we are grateful and we are thankful. It's while I was putting the sermon together, and it's a sermon that I've preached before, but I think it's relevant for what is happening now. Christ is still, we're talking about the Christ in this crisis. And I went to the scriptures, and it's a very familiar scripture that we're used to, all of us. Something that we have quoted, and my boys probably can quote the scripture because they know more scripture than me now. But it's relevant. I've been watching the television for the last umpteen weeks with what is happening globally, and there is some amount of panic and fear that has not just gripped Jamaica but has gripped the entire world. And I was watching the news last week, the business news, and they're saying that the Jamaican stock market since January has lost over $500 billion. That's crazy. In 1 week, the Jamaica Stock Exchange lost $272 billion. Our health system is failing. Our financial sector is failing. The IMF, the World Bank says that we are actually in a recession. There are so many persons who are uncertain about next 2 weeks because there will be laying off of jobs and people will be losing their jobs. So there is a fear gripping not just Jamaica. When you look at what is happening to our neighbors in New York, and you're seeing what is happening in the health sector. I have a cousin and my mom who works in the health sector, and it's all gloom and doom. But the songwriter says, and the psalmist says, that our help, and you know, I was excited when I hear Nicola raise that song, because our help, while everything else is failing around us, our help comes from God. The WHO is trying to find a vaccine for this coronavirus, and they can't. The financial institutions are trying to mitigate or putting things in place so that we do not crumble as a nation or as a world, because the recession the economies are contracting. But we are looking for something that we can't find in the world, but our help. I don't know who I'm talking to, but our help. One of my friends, I was talking to her on WhatsApp, and she said, boy, every time she look on her stocks online, she have to take a glass of wine because she keeps seeing our stocks devalued. But I want to say that in 2008, when there was a global recession, come on to somebody, there were many who lost their minds, but the believers stood on the authority of the word. Come on, somebody. And the word of God says he will, not might, but he will supply all of our needs according to his riches in glory. So while we are embracing as a world what is happening, let us embrace what the scripture says. Let us stand on the authority of what the word says. And the word says that he will supply. No, I have not even quoted my scriptures yet, but my scripture reference this morning will be taken from the 23rd Psalm. It's my duty to remind you, my God, the 23rd Psalm. And you may turn your Bibles to the 23rd Psalm. I hope that everybody have their Bibles. We are in church. My help cometh from the Lord. Hallelujah. The 23rd Psalms, and it reads, the Lord is my shepherd. Well, that's what my Bible says. I don't know if anybody else's Bible says the Lord was in the past. But the Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the path of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear absolutely no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of mine enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil, my cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Let us pray. Father, we thank you that we can gather in a setting like this, unconventional. But we're good because there are more than two of us here. And I know where two or more are gathered. You're here. We know, we feel your presence. You live here. You reside here. But those who are at home, God, I pray in the name of Jesus that the word will reach them wherever they are this morning. It is a reminder of who you are, the Christ in the crisis. So we give this time to you. Have your own way, I pray. Amen. Now, this particular Psalms, and we love to quote the Psalms. The Psalms is considered to be the hymn book for the Old and New Testament, the hymn book of the Bible. But this particular Psalm was written by David. Now, we can understand why David would use this sort of a comparison, because David himself was a shepherd. He understood the role and the characteristic of a shepherd. And he did not write this particular psalm when he was king of Israel or when things was great in his life. In fact, David penned one of the most articulate and most renowned psalms of all times when he himself was going through a crisis, because David was at a lonely place in his life running away from Saul. But I like the utterances of David, because he never spoke in the past. He spoke in the present and continuous. He says, the Lord is my shepherd. And I know things are not looking good on the outside. Come on, David. I know that things are not looking the way we wanted for. Look, last year, Jamaica's stock market was the best in the world. The global economy was growing fast, and the IMF, nobody feel lend no money. But now we see a turning around of things. What do we do when we are in a crisis? I am not sure. I work in the private sector. I work at a private school. I don't know what tomorrow holds. But one thing I'm sure of is that tomorrow is in the palm of his hands. He is not at all surprised. In fact, before the very foundation of the world, he already understood and knew that this would have happened. No. And so the world is looking for answers. The world is trying to find answers. But the answer is Christ. And so when we look at David, David had nothing. He was running away, hiding in the backside of the desert in some cave. And then David, in the lowest time of his life, started to pen. And sometimes we need to talk to ourselves when we are in the lowest point in our lives. Sometimes we need to seclude ourselves and start to talk to God, and we start to declare things. David made a declarative statement. He said, the Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want. So yes, my stocks are, we are loose stocks. Yes, I don't know what's going to happen with my job. Yes, I don't have money piled up in the bank in reserve. Yes, things look uncertain. Yes, I have a family to feed, but the Lord is. Oh my God, he says he's our very help when we are in trouble. And so there are so many believers who are in fear, but I choose faith over fear. Fear cripples faith. Faith cometh by hearing the word. But please be reminded that fear also cometh by hearing. Also, you hear something, you see something, and fear grips you, Roger. But I want us to remember this morning that the word never changes. And if we stand on the authority of the word, he will supply. He will supply. Out of nowhere, he will supply. In 2008, I'm going to tell you a story. In 2008, I got married. 2008. 12 years ago, it seems so short. I'm still in my honeymoon phase. And in 2008, I got married to the girl of my dreams, my wife. And I was one of those guys who was heavily invested in the unregulated schemes. So I had some money here in Mae Daisy, I had a little money there in Olin, I had a little money there in Cash Plus. And every day I'd go on the internet and I would just open and see the dollars, the zeros adding and the whatever. Happy. And then all in the twinkling of an eye, I never forgot, I got married the 26th of July, 2008. I was on my honeymoon, I started sending an email to one of the institutions and I said, boy, I need some money when I come off from my honeymoon. Blah, 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 blah. Now I watch news or nothing, because I'm still a honeymoon. 2 weeks in paradise. And I left paradise and came home to $0 and 0 cents. All the unregulated schemes got shut down. I lost all my money, all my savings. But my God, come on, somebody. Not once have I ever gone to bed without food. Not once I had to go and knock on my neighbor's door and say, I beg you something. Because I've never seen the righteous forsaken. Neither is seed bed bread. And I want to say to you this morning, you have to stand on what the word of God says. Now is the time to stand on the word. Now is the time to trust him, even when you can't trace him, even in the midst of adversity. God, I'm standing on what your word says. They that trust in the Lord shall be, not might be, but shall be as Mount Zion and shall not be moved. So no matter what the economists are saying, a cattle on a thousand belongs to my God. I don't care what they are saying on the stock market. Come on, somebody. I am steadfast. I'm standing on the word. He shall supply all of my needs. So I want to remind the believers this morning that the Lord that we serve, our shepherd, he will provide. There are three very important characteristics of a shepherd. And I think that was what David was getting into. There are three things that a shepherd must do. The shepherd must provide. He must protect. And he will preserve. Let me remind you of that. The shepherd will provide. He will protect. And he will what? Preserve. Jesus in John 10:10 says, he says, I am the good shepherd. He never said, I'm trying to be a shepherd. He says, I am the good shepherd. Not an ordinary shepherd. Not somebody that was hired to do a job. He says, I am the good shepherd. The good shepherd in this time. This is a, you know, it's a good time to be alive. And I tell you why. Because the world has always been questioning God. Let me see what God is going to do for Uno. Now is the time for God, and he will prove himself. He says, I am the good shepherd. Me no slumber, David, and I no sleep. I don't slumber and I don't sleep. Because David, Reverend Gibbs, Roger, is always on the shepherd's mind. Him say, if one tree are hurt, you might go for him. That is the God that we serve. He is our provider. Hallelujah. He is the good shepherd. So he provides. Philippians 4:13. He will supply all your needs. Now, it baffles me. And I tell you why it baffles me when I read the text. And every time I go through the 23rd Psalm, I'm a little befuddled. Because the first four chapters, the first three chapters are so fabulously written. I like that part. David had my attention there. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He made me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restored my soul. He leadeth me in the path of righteousness for his name's sake. Now, the part of the text that I had a serious problem with, because it seems as if it is out of character, is the part that says, yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death. Now, we have a problem with that part there. That part must have been David probably was sleeping when he was writing that part, David. It not belonging to the psalm. It is, might I suggest, one of the beliefs of Christianity, or one of the beliefs of the followers, that we should never experience a valley experience. The entire world is now in a valley experience. The entire world is in the valley of the shadow. Ask Italy. Italy's prime minister is looking up to the hills. Oh my God. They are in a valley. Death is around. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, only the believers can say, but I will fear no evil. Only the believer can say, I will fear no evil. Why? Because he is with me. Every step I take, the Lord is with me. The angel of the Lord encampeth round about them that fear. That is why, you know, I'm home. I have to obey what them say. My wife cuss me every day because I want to go on the road. I have to be obedient. And I understand the implications of this coronavirus. But I am not going to sit at home and imprison myself in fear. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. Because who is with us? And if God be for us, Reverend Gibbs, if God be for the church, if God be for the believers, if God be for your family, my God, who? This plague or this whatever pandemic, you know, when in the book of Exodus 13 to 23, you can read it in your own personal time, when the Lord spoke to the people of Israel and he says, when you go in, just take the blood of the lamb and put it over your doorpost. I want to suggest to some of the church members and the believers, you need to walk into every room in your house and begin to plead the blood against the coronavirus, because once the death angel come, he will have to do what? Passover. Plead the blood over your children. Plead the blood over your spouses, because the blood has not lost its power. The blood is still efficacious. I plead the blood over Christopher and Cameron. I plead the blood over Cadian. I walk into my kitchen and I say, I plead the blood. I walk into the living room, I plead the blood. I walk in the dining room, I plead the blood. Over the bed, on the bed, I plead the blood. There is no room in my family for the corona. The blood. When the death angel comes, when the virus comes, the virus does not have power over the blood. He protects. Isaiah 59:19 says, when the enemy comes in like a flood, and right now there is a flood of the virus is just overwhelming everybody. But when the enemy comes in like a flood, the word of God says the Spirit of God will lift up a standard. Come on, somebody. And lift up a standard so high the virus can't get over. So wide he can't get around. We must trust what the word says. When it comes in like a flood, every news channel in the world, David, Corona. You know, I was home. It took the news 45 minutes from 7 to 7:45 to talk about the coronavirus. 45 minutes. The enemy, the virus is like a flood. But my God says, what does the word says? The Spirit of God. My God, somebody need to get out of them house and walk around the house and march around the house and plead the blood around the house. I hear that the virus is in Westchester. I don't care where it is. The Spirit of the Lord will lift up a standard. Because he protects. That is one of the role or the characteristics of a shepherd. He provides, but he also protects. What is he talking about? The rod, you know, growing up I used to think that all shepherds have a walking problem. Because if all shepherds walk with a walking stick. I kid you not, is until I was about 35, round about there, I said, but why is it every shepherd have a walking stick? Right? So is it a requirement to be a shepherd that you have a walking deficiency or something? But it is, at an adult age, I realized that the hook, and it's a staff. It's not a walking stick. The hook on the top is to hold the sheep and pull them back in line so they don't go over the edge. And you keep them in line. Come on, somebody. He's protecting. His hands are always on his saints and the believers. He is protecting. The angels of the Lord encamped round about them that fear him. He says he will give his angels charge over you. He protects. Hallelujah. And I thank you, God, for your protection. I thank you, God, that while the world is in turmoil and people, persons are dying left, right, and center, I thank you for your protection. I thank you that your hand is still upon my life. I thank you that your hand is still upon my family. I thank you that while everybody is fearful, I am still living by faith and by the authority of the word. I thank you. I thank you, God, that you're still calling my name. Even in the midst of this crisis, you are still the Christ. In the crisis. Yea, though I walk through, this too shall pass. It's a season that will change the face of humanity forever. Just as the 9/11 changed how we travel. I used to enjoy traveling before 9/11. You just walk up to the airport, jump on the plane like a taxi, and you're gone. Now you have checkpoint one, checkpoint two, take off your shoes three, take off your belt four, take off your shirt five, go in and scan off, scan all your ribs and your kidney and your liver. Then you go to one next thing, then take, come on, it's not fun. But understand that there's an agenda and that this will change how we interact, how we communicate. It will change. I never thought I would one day be standing in a church preaching to the empty benches. Never. I think only bathroom sermon I could have preached. So I used to preach in the bathroom and baptize the toilet paper and the soap and raise the toothpaste from the dead, all them things. But now I have to be looking and saying, we are now in uncharted territory. But what the enemy meant bad, God will turn it around for good. Come on, somebody. So while we used to have an audience of about 300 people, now you can reach an audience of millions. So what the enemy meant for bad, God will turn it around for good. Hallelujah. He protects. The valley experience, David, at the church, the modern church, we've
We've gotten so comfortable. We've gotten so full and we've gotten so sophisticated. We've gotten so eloquent. This is a wake-up call. I hear people talking about, we shouldn't obey what the Prime Minister says and we should come out and not into that argument. But if you have a relationship with God already, some people, we need to be here on a Sunday morning to feel good about our spiritual lives. If you already had a relationship with God, because I believe this is where we're going to be headed one day, where this four wall will mean nothing. But we thank you, God. We thank you. We thank you for your protection. My God, I feel... sorry, you know, Sunday morning, I said I run up and down, but if I run the camera, I'm not going to follow me, so I can't run this morning. I'm going to have to behave myself. I feel like to skip. The psalmist then moves from the valley experience. And he says, thou preparest a table before me in the presence of mine enemies. Thou anointed my head with oil. My cup runneth over. This is the part that I want to remind you of. It says, surely, not might be. Surely, not could be. Surely, goodness and mercy shall follow me. Surely. So even in this crisis, Reverend Gibbs, goodness and mercy shall follow me, Roger. Even when things are not going right globally, goodness and mercy shall follow me. I don't care what they're saying and the doom and gloom. Goodness and mercy has got to follow me all the days of my life. And I will dwell. He that dwelleth in the secret place. And now is the time to dwell in that secret place of the Most High. They will abide under the shadow of the... I will say of the Lord is my refuge and my fortress. My God, in him will I trust. Who are we going to trust in this crisis? While some trust in horses and chariots, I will trust in the name of the Lord. And the name of the Lord is a strong tower. I beg some people to start running to that strong tower to be saved. The three Hebrew boys, he preserves. The three Hebrew boys, and I've preached the Hebrew boys story a couple of times. I like them. I like those boys. They themselves were in a crisis. They were in a crisis and they knew what the enemy could do. They knew the strength and the power of Nebuchadnezzar. They knew at the snap of a finger, Nebuchadnezzar could get them killed. But they knew their God also. I want to ask the church, do you know your God? Because in the crisis that those three Hebrew boys were, I cannot imagine. Me, David, and Roger, three Hebrew boys, three Jamaican boys, stand up. And Nebuchadnezzar said, you know do what? And him said, turn up the furnace 7 times hotter. Roger, I'm going to be honest with you. When if my gosh and feel too hot, I'm going to start to think and waver. But those boys, for not 1 minute, wavered. They had a if not clause. Them said, look here, we're not bowing because we know our God will deliver us. He will. But if he does not deliver us, we're still not going to bow. No, I'm saying that when the scripture says, when the guys who turn up the furnace, the soldiers, when they took them to the furnace, the heat killed those guys. And the three Hebrew boys was in the furnace and singed. He preserved them in the fire. I want to say to you and you and you that God will preserve you in the crisis. He says, I am there with you always. So even everything that is happening, he says, I will preserve you. In the fire, preserve. In the economic collapse, preserve. With the health crisis, I will preserve you. He's all powerful. I will preserve. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I am happy. I am happy that I am alive. Because if somebody had said this to me years ago, or if I was born after, I wouldn't believe. Nobody could have prepared me for what is happening now. My wife, the woman, she cussed, she said, every day you're actually on watching Contagion and all of these movies that predicted some virus. And I'm watching the documentary that they had built last year, November, December, that tells you exactly what would have happened in January. It is unbelievable on Netflix. So I am home watching these things. And my wife said, you're hooked up on this thing. I said, no, if somebody did tell me, I wouldn't believe. And I think it's a movie. And I'm seeing what is happening before my eyes. And then you've got to begin to say to yourself, are we prepared for what is to come? Are we prepared? But he preserves. In the midst of the crisis, he preserves. In the midst of the crisis, he will provide. In the midst of the crisis, he will protect. And now is the time when we are home to start to go back to the scriptures. Start to look at what the word says. Whose report will you believe? Whose report? Where is your help coming from? Where? Where? Are we going to look to the banks? Right now, the Minister of Health now have a clue. They're doing a fantastic job. But they can't fix this. They are putting a band-aid on a big sore. The Prime Minister is being stately. Can't fix this. The Governor, Mr. Biles, can't fix the economy. China try to find cure. Europe try to find cure. US try to find cure. Who are we going to look to in this crisis? Who are we going to look to in this crisis? I will lift up mine eyes to the hills. Even when I'm in the valley, I am lifting up mine eyes to the hills from comet or help. And I want to say to us, that our help comes from the Lord. I want to say to us, comes what may, hell or high water, our help comes from the Lord. I want to say to us finally, that the shepherd still and will provide. The shepherd still and will protect. The shepherd still and will preserve. So those who are in internet land, trust what the word says this morning. You're in your living room. You're wavering what is going to happen. Trust what the word says. Now is the time to pray. Now is the time to seek him. And now is the time to stand on his word. Hallelujah. Where is the musician? Where's Nicola? I want to close with that song, My Help. Come, praise and worship team. Roger. I want to close with that song to just remind somebody this morning who is fearful of what is to come and unknown. Your help. Your help. Your help. Your help. Your help. Your help. Come it from God. Your help. Hallelujah. 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 They that trust in the Lord shall be as Mount Zion and shall not be moved. Are you trusting him this morning? Your faith wavering this morning, are you trusting him? our help. Come, Nicola, come help me, because I can't sing, and you know that. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
I will lift my eyes to the hills, from whence cometh my help. My help cometh from the Lord, the Lord which made heaven and earth. He said he would not suffer thy foot to be moved. The Lord is keeping thee. He will not slumber nor sleep. Oh, the Lord is thy keeper. The Lord is the same. Upon thy right hand, upon thy right hand. Smite thee by day, nor the moon by night. He shall preserve my soul, even forevermore. My help, my help, my
I want you, wherever you are this morning, to just stand and join us in that worship song. And Nicarlo, I want you to remind them that their help, so your help coming from the Lord. Somebody needs to be reminded this morning where their help comes from.
Oh, oh, the Lord is my keeper.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Our help, our help. Hallelujah. 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 Let us pray this morning as we close this service. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Father, we thank you. We thank you that our help truly comes from you this morning. I thank you, Lord, that your word says it. I thank you that we can believe your word. You said that you are the good shepherd, and we believe that. And that you're going to
gonna take care of your sheep. And so God, this morning we come to you as a church, as a nation, as a people. Hallelujah. There's so much fear, so much anxiety, so much sickness, so much health issues, death. God, we call on you this morning. Arise, O God, and let your enemies be scattered. Arise, God. God, we declare that you are still the Christ in this crisis. I speak a prophetic word. I declare that you are the Christ. I declare that you can do exceedingly abundantly that we could ask, think, or imagine. God, we stand on your word. We pray for those who are in hospital, those who are in isolation, those who are in quarantine. We pray for those who are sick. You said by your stripes, they are already healed in the name of Jesus. We send a word to every respiratory problem in every hospital, in every home. Those who are asymptomatic and those who are sick and don't even know they are sick, we send that word of healing in the name of Jesus. I pray that our people will replace fear with faith. Faith is the substance of things hoped for, and the evidence of things not seen. But we have not seen it yet, but we believe that it will come to pass. We pray for the church, that now is the time for the church to rise up and let their voices be heard. We pray for the church that we will open up our prayer closets and take out and dust it out. Get the cobweb out. Now is the time to seek you, Lord. For they that seek you will find you. And we need to find you as a church. So we thank you. We thank you that this crisis, you will be glorified through this crisis. We thank you that what the enemy or a man has meant for bad, you will turn it around for good. We thank you. We thank you that families in this time of quarantine will find back themselves. We pray you bind families together with cords that cannot be broken, because the house for them not a bar for go, because the bar them lock. Come on, somebody. I pray that the families will be restored in this time. Every broken home, we send a word of healing in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. I pray that we'll come back to our first love, which is you. Have full control. Have full control of this nation. We pray for our Prime Minister. We pray for the Minister of Health. We pray for the doctors who are on the front line battling this virus. We pray for strength and we pray for wisdom in the name of Jesus. We pray for your covering and your protection over those who have to deal with the coronavirus patient in the name of Jesus. We pray for families in New York. It's overrun and overwhelmed. We pray for families in Europe, in England, in Italy. We pray for those who are in China. My God, we pray that your grace will be made sufficient. We pray for strength in the name of Jesus. We pray, my God, that you begin to call your people. I pray that your people will repent. 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 And pray. Seek your face. So we thank you. We thank you. Come on, church. We lift our hands and we say thank you that you are still providing. We thank you that you will still provide. We thank you that you are protecting. We thank you that you will still protect. We thank you that you are preserving. We thank you that you will always preserve in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
The Lord, we thank God for his word this morning to us. He is still God. There is a Christ for the crisis. He provides, he preserves, and he protects. We thank God for Minister Jones this morning. Just in way of announcements, we ask you to join us online on Tuesday between 7 and 8 p.m. So it's this Tuesday between 7 and 8 p.m. for Bible study. And on Sunday, we ask you to join us that Sunday coming April 5 for communion service between 9 a.m. and 10 a.m. We invite all Christians to participate in the Lord's Supper, so you can use your bread and grape juice. So in preparation for that, just get bread, pizza crackers, grape juice, and participate with us online on Sunday, April 5. Secondly, we ask that if you desire prayer or pastoral counseling, we ask you to call our office numbers, which is 988-0381 or 998-5613. So for the numbers, I'll repeat them. It's 988-0381 or 998-5613 for prayer and or pastoral counseling. And it's between the hours of 10 a.m. to 4 p.m. Monday to Wednesday. So that's Monday to Wednesday, 10 a.m. to 4 p.m. What a good time we have had in the Lord. Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Bless the name of Jesus. So we wish for you a prosperous and a healthy week this week. Remember to keep safe. Keep your social distance and listen for the government's directives as we proceed throughout this time. Remember, Christ in this season, in our crisis, provides, he protects, and he preserves. So may the Lord bless you. May the grace of the Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God the Father, the full fellowship of the Holy Spirit, the Comforter, rest, remain, and abide with us all, now and forevermore. Amen. God bless you.